Hi, and welcome to this Tech Insights video. My name is Mary, and I'm an application engineer here at IFM Effector. In today's video, we are going to go over how to program the SU ultrasonic flow meter using the display and push buttons. So let's get started. So here you have the Learn More site for our SU ultrasonic flow meters. Under the Setup and Support section, you can find the installation guidelines, as well as the device configuration pages. Within the device configuration, we go over the different parameterization softwares we offer, such as Mineo Configure and Mineo Blue. If you scroll further down on the page, we go over commonly used terms within our menu structure, such as the switching outputs using HNO and HNC, as well as the analog start point and analog end point for our analog output scaling, as well as IMPS and IMPR, which are used for the pulse output when monitoring the totalization. If you scroll further down, we go over the different display options, as well as step-by-step guidelines on how to navigate the menu to specific parameters. So now let me take you to the SU device itself and show you how to use the installation wizard, as well as change different parameters using the display and push buttons. So here we have the SU8020. This specific part number has a G1 process connection. For other options with different process connections and sizes, please check out the Select Products page on our Learn More site. Here you can see we have the flow direction arrow etched on the side of the sensor, and now let me show you the TFT display with the PFA window for chemical compatibility. In this example, you are going to see the signal quality LED flashing red because we do not currently have any media passing through the sensor itself. Here you can see we have the flow rate set for liters per minute, and the totalized value set for liters out of the box. Now, if you want to go into the menu, you'll press this enter button. And out of the box, the first thing you will see is this guided installation wizard. If you want to go into this installation wizard, you'll press yes. And then it's going to ask you to select the display rotation. You can confirm, or if you press down and enter, it will rotate the display. And if you keep pressing rotate, it'll turn it 90 degrees each time, and when you get it to where you want it to be, you'll press up and press confirm. Next, it's gonna ask you what language you'd like. I'm gonna press English. And now it's gonna ask you to set the direction of the media flow. Positive would mean that flow is flowing in the direction of the arrow, and negative would mean it's flowing against the arrow. So you'll just press enter to select that. And next, it's gonna ask you to set up each of your outputs. For output one, you can decide to set it for flow, temperature, or diagnostics. I'm going to set it for flow. And then it's going to ask you for your units. I'm going to select liters per minute. And next, it's going to ask you what you want your output to be. A hysteresis normally open or normally closed output, a window normally open or normally closed output, a frequency output, or a pulsed output, or a totalizer set point. For this example, I'm going to set it for a pulsed output to show you how to set up the totalizer. So now it's going to ask me what I want my decimal point to be for my totalizer set point, and I'm just going to keep it at C.CCC, but if you were to press up or down, you can see that decimal point change. So you can press enter when you're at what you want it to be. And next you can set the IMPS value. This value is at which point you're going to get a pulsed output. So if I set it for 0.1 liters, every time 0.1 liters passes through the device, you will get a pulse. Now it's going to ask me about output 2. For this example, I'm going to set output 2 for temperature. It's going to ask you to set your units. And now it's going to ask you to configure what you want output 2 to be. For this example, I'm going to set analog. And now you can set your ASP and AEP values. Your ASP is your analog start point, and at which value will be represented by 4 milliamps. So for this example, it's factory set for negative 20, but if you press and hold up or down, you can change that. So I will set it for 0. And next, it's going to ask you to set your analog endpoint, which is represented by 20 milliamps, and I'll keep that at 100 C. Now it's going to ask you what you want the output 2 to do in the case of a failure. If you set it for off for the analog output, it'll drop to 3.5 milliamps. If you set it for on, it'll rise to 21.5 milliamps. So I will keep that set for off. And now it's going to ask you what you want to show on the display. You can show just flow, flow and temperature. In this case, I'm going to select to see all values. And now it's going to ask you if you've completed your guide. I'll press yes. You'll see it says installation complete. And now you can see your menu in the run mode. And I can see my flow rate, temperature, the totalized value, and my signal quality. So after completing the installation guideline wizard, if there are any parameters you'd still wish to change, you can go back into the menu by pressing this enter button. The first thing you will see are the basic settings of your output 1 and output 2 configurations. But if you'd like to see more advanced settings, you can go into the extended functions menu by pressing enter. Here you have your output 1 and output 2 configurations, in which you could change which process value you are monitoring, as well as the function of the output. To get out of this menu, you would press back. In addition, you can see different configuration menus, as well as the totalizer menu, in which you could reset the totalizer value. You could see the totalizer count, as well as the lifetime totalizer the sensor has seen. Next, we have the display menu if you want to rotate the display or change any colors of the display. We have diagnostic information, a simulation menu in which you can test the sensor. We have the device info of the sensor, and we have where you can factory reset the sensor. To get out of the extended functions menu, you will press back. And then if you want to get out of the menu altogether, you will press back again. And now you are at the run mode where you can see your measured values. So there you have it. That concludes this Tech Insights video on programming the SU ultrasonic flow meter using the display and push buttons. As always, you can check out our Learn More pages on our website for helpful information on any of our products. Feel free to contact our service center at 1-800-441-8246 or email into info.us@ifm.com for any questions. Thank you for your time and have a great day.